vision without action is a daydream. Action without a vision is a nightmare. Japanese proverb. A person will never be fully satisfied with themselves if they spend their whole life trying to achieve what they think they're supposed to. I'm Surya Venigalla, and I think that we should explore that before you begin measuring how far you are on your path to reach success, consider what is actually at the end. One way to begin is to simply ask yourself the question, how do you measure success? Is it based on how funny you are, how rich you are, how good looking, or how powerful? Truth is, the answer to those questions is both yes and no. Success in itself is an idea, and it's subjective. Due to the fact it could change based on the person, circumstance, or perspective, it's impractical to say this is the universal version and way to measure success. Because then we would all have the answer. And, well, we don't. Depending on the person, place, or time, one may measure it with money, another with time spent with family, another with prestige or honor or power. You may look at Jeff Bezos and say he's the most successful person because he's the richest man on the planet, while others may say Barack Obama or Donald Trump because they're the president of the United States and held the most power in the nation. Maybe even Steve Jobs or Lori Grainer because they're great entrepreneurs. When you look at all of these people, what do they have in common? They're considered successful. So since they're considered successful, should we all strive to be like them? Absolutely not. Success is not a set standard that once you pass this line, you fall into the category of successful. It's all up to you. In this world, we only have a limited amount of time. And sometimes it's cut short, and sometimes it's not. So it's up to each of us to define what success means to us. Achieving anything doesn't have any value or worth unless we define it as success. You can't measure success without knowing what it means to ourselves. It's as simple as this. You can't measure your height in pounds. So realize you shouldn't be measuring how well your math grades are if you want to become a musician. Therefore, it is important not to get lost in comparing yourself to others, because chances are you're on a different path than them. Another point is, it's impossible to be seen as successful through everyone's eyes. Because of all these different influenced versions of success, you can't satisfy everyone. So why not become successful in your own eyes? Achieve something you will be proud of yourself for. Remember, the world will only see the outside and the numbers, not the story, the truth, the journey, or the differences. It's important to realize these things, and society doesn't necessarily. Not everybody starts off in the same position. Let's imagine a simple scenario. Say a homeless person gets a job that pays for $80,000, and another person gets a job that pays for $140,000 in the same company. From the outside, it may seem like the second person is more successful. However, when you look deeper than the surface, the first person started from nothing, and the second person's parent owns the company and did not necessarily have to work for that job. The first person should not compare themselves to the second, but instead to where they were a year ago, on the streets. And the second person, likewise, should see that they've had the same job and not improved, instead of comparing themselves to the second. Many people are born with or into disadvantages, while others unknowingly have advantages that help them. Somebody might have taken one step to get to the 100th step, while someone else might have had to take 99 just to get to the same exact place. Society has a distorted version of success due to the fact it doesn't necessarily consider where someone may have started, their obstacles, hurdles, or differences. Society needs to learn to bring awareness and recognize efforts, not just blindly results. When you understand how unjust society's version of success is, you realize it's not the best way to measure your own. So, when you don't measure up to society's version, don't feel sorry for yourself. Because truth is, you don't need to become successful. Don't focus on what place you finished, but instead, how long your race was. Personally, measure success based on what you believe makes you happy, not how society views your progress. When I think of someone I consider successful, my mind always goes to my father. My father came from nothing when he came to America from India. Then he got a job in a company and reached a high position. However, it never satisfied him. Society viewed him as a very successful person, as he reached a high position and had a steady income. However, that's not what his definition was. So nowadays, even as he struggled with the lack of evolution, stagnancy, he decided to pursue a career of his own and set up his own company, and he became much more content. Now in these days, even in a room full of billionaires and presidents, my dad is just as successful because he views success through how much happiness you get out of work. Although everyone has a distinct version of success, most people conform to societal views of success and ergo fall into the trap of false happiness and fulfillment. Success should be defined by what you believe makes you happy and your life purpose, not how society views it. A goal that you full-heartedly strive and wish for essentially will lead to more happiness than a goal set by society. Moreover, people should not follow societal views that don't acknowledge hardships, circumstances, or personal interests. Rather, people should follow their source of happiness and own wishes. A life spent fulfilling others' wishes may or may not be content, but a life spent pursuing one's own goal and wishes is a life surely to be successful. Thank you.